Chris Isaak is here with Kenny, and they're going to do a song. So we'll listen to you right now.
Without further ado.
Drive your Mustang down to where you hang out, alone without a friend. Girls walk by you, some in fact have tried you. Once they tried, they never tried again. Except the new girl. Except the new girl. Alone, lonesome, trusting no one, they say you've never had a friend. People talk about you, they say they doubt you really ever let anybody in. Except the new girl. Except the new girl.
Ready for the big stuff?
Sure, why not?
See him smile, he don't care. He says he loves her, or he'll always love her. See him smile, it seems fair. He should finally find her. He should finally hold her. There's no one except for Natalie.
I said,
except for Natalie. Except for Natalie.
Thank you.
Sounds better.
Last time I remember,
you know, you want to be in our video? I got a great idea. We're on a beach.
Oh, yeah.
Can we talk about this?
Like cricket games?
It's different than that, really.
Yeah. A little more for adults, though.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean? A more kind of an artistic idea.
That could be fun. Let your people call my people and then.
I don't have people. I don't got people. Can I have Kenny call them?
Okay. I'll be your people.
I call Kenny, call my mother, and then we'll see what happens. Nice to have you over, and it's a real treat, like I said, to have you. The album San Francisco Day has been out for a while now. How's it going?
Well, I think we got the goals, and that's good.
That's good.
My dad said, you know, my dad, first time I gave him, I had a gold record, I gave it to my dad, he said, you know, Fats Domino has a gold record. So,
oh, wow.
Can't go wrong.
That's good. And everybody keeps, you know, seems to think that this album was a real departure from the other three that you did. I don't find so much.
I like you. Deep. Okay? I mean, oh, the man sort of way.
Do you agree with it? With the fact that it's different? Do you find that? Or?
Well, we got more organ playing on it. And more sloppy guitar playing than ever before, because I played a lot of guitar, but I think it, me singing, Kenny singing harmony,
it's same, not very different.
Same band, Jimmy Wilsey on there playing guitar, so not that radical different, no.
But were you inspired differently when you did it, or?
I was living in the same place and driving the same car and hanging out with the same people, so not really that much changed, no, not really.
That's great. Let's talk about your movie career, because there's a new movie coming out called Little Buddha, I think, in December, and you have a major part in it. Like, I remember seeing you in tons of other movies before, but I think this one is...
But only a little...
Yeah, a little bit. Part, but this is like more of a...
Yeah, I'm on there. I'm acting up a storm. It's this time I'm in there a lot. I learned a lot doing those other movies, even though I was only in for a little bit of time. I learned that what you do, and you... This might be helpful with Kenny. I think he's going to go into movies.
Yeah.
The thing you do, Kenny, is when somebody else is talking or acting,
mm-hmm.
then you kind of walk over, whatever, you pretend you dropped your pen, and you go stand by them, and you get your head right by their head. Mm. They can't cut you out later. That's the trick. See, Laurence Olivier, he charged like $2,000 to learn that from him.
Yeah, wow.
I just give you that.
Thank you.
Kind of a guy I am.
And how did you get the part? How did it work? Tell me about the movie and tell me how it happened and everything.
It's a weird thing that somebody had given him a picture of me, Bertolucci, the director, and he had this picture, and I guess he was going through people in Hollywood, and finally at the end he said, well, who's this guy? Bring him in. And I came in to meet him, and the only reason that I didn't really go into audition. I came in because I just wanted to meet Bertolucci. Because I'd just seen his, he had a movie, was playing on TV, and I'd seen Last Tango, and I thought, wow. They said, you want to go, would you like to meet Bernardo Bertolucci? I went, sure. Gonna cost me anything? Sure, I'll go. And I met him, and the first thing he said was, no, he's too young, and look at his hair.
He didn't like your hair.
Yeah, I remember he said, he went, can you do something else with your hair? And I was like, what else? I don't know what is, you know.
A ponytail, maybe.
So the first thing they did when they got me for the movie was like, can you wash all the grease out of your hair? Yeah. So, you know, they tried to make me look like, I look clean cut in the movie. I look like I could get credit.
No, no.
You know what I mean? I'm wearing, like I'm going to a bank or something.
What part do you play?
I'm an architect. And I'm married to Bridget Fonda, and we have a little 9-year-old boy. And one day we come home, and there's a bunch of Buddhist monks in the house, and they say, we think your son is a reincarnation of a Tibetan Lama. This is something I think a lot of people can relate to.
Sure.
I think a lot of people in their life have had a similar experience. Perhaps you have, or someone you know, usually. A lot of people tell me, that's my life. That's me.
It happened to me,
yeah,
too.
Yeah.
So you went to Bhutan.
Bhutan.
How was it there? Must have been a thrill to shoot over there.
It was beautiful. They don't have TV over there. I'm not kidding. It's not because they don't. I mean, it's illegal.
Really?
Yeah, TV's illegal. I guess they tried it for a while, and then the king king was walking through the house one day and looked and went, "Hey, this sucks. Get this out of here." And they made it illegal.
How's the music over there? Were you in touch with the music scene at all?
They don't know. They have no idea. They didn't know. I was in a Buddhist monastery. It was like 400 years old. It was a trip. It was all around me are all these like Buddhist monks, shaved heads, and they're all like kind of just looking at me. You bring out a newspaper, they'd come look at it because it was all new to them. And I had my guitar there, and I was playing one day, and I'm going, you know, do you know Elvis Presley? You know, and they said, no. You know Beatles? No. Madonna? They don't know that.
So you taught them all these songs?
I just said, hey, here's something I wrote. It's called Love Me Tender. They're going, wow, this guy, I'm pretty much considered a musical genius over there. You know? Hard Day's Night. This is one I'm working on. It's called Hard Day's Night. Huh? I wrote it for you.
Did you get a chance to learn anything about their culture, about their religion?
Nah, pretty much. I just went in there as like an interloper. You know, I just pretty much was gumming up the works for them. I tried to learn something, but you know, you're only there for about, I was there from like September till around Christmas, and you're working every day on the movie set. You learn something about their culture. The main thing you learn is like you meet people every day, and like, are they nice? And the people were really nice. I say that. Beautiful country, and the people were great.
They have great voices when they
They do chanting.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Yeah, I went someplace, they had a big ceremony that one of the high priests had died, and there was hundreds of these monks in a room chanting. And I walked in, I'm the only white guy. There's all these guys in big ceremonial robes. I walk in, I sat down, and everybody in the place kind of keeps chanting, but their eyes come towards me. And I felt like, man, of all times in the world, don't sneeze, don't laugh, don't do anything. I just sat there like this, and after about 5 minutes of sitting there, the head guy in the very front goes, like, points at me and goes, like this, like, come up. And I thought, I kept looking, he's not pointing at me, is he? And like that. And finally, I came up there, and he goes, you know, you don't have to stay, this is gonna be like 5 hours. And then he goes, you wanna get something to eat?
That's wonderful.
Yeah, the head guy right in the middle of the ceremony, I'm going, no, I'll go sit down. I thought, hey, I'll sit here for 10 hours and just don't notice me. But they were chanting, and there's like one or two guys who can sing good, the best singers, and you notice that those guys sing real loud and everybody else kind of mumbles. Kind of like our band,
yeah,
right?
Exactly. Yeah, exactly.
I'm the guy who mumbles.
How was it to work with a director that's European, like Bertolucci? Did you find that it was different?
Do you ever have a dog growing up?
I said,
do you ever have a dog when you're growing up?
Yeah.
Your dog doesn't really understand what you say, right? That's how I was on the set. Like, they would talk. It was all in Italian. Everything was in Italian. So it was like, you know, hey, Chris Isaak. I'd be over there and I go like that. And it was like, you know, if they go, what are they, what is Isaac? And then I go. And it's like, you know, it was pretty much the tone of their voice that I went by. I don't really understand what they say, the tone of their voice.
You know? But he would direct you in English.
No, he would talk like, he would be like, he'd go in Italian, and then at the very end, he'd go, Chris, stand over there, don't move. That was about it.
So you did it pretty much yourself and everything.
I would try to direct myself. He would give me directions if I begged him. And then sometimes I would turn to the lighting director who spoke English a little bit, and I would say, where should I stand to get light on me? That was about it.
Oh, wow, that's good. So do you have any other plans in the movie world?
Right now we're out living in a bus for a while.
How's that going?
Well, it's pretty good. I mean, should we talk about that? I mean, now the bass player's been wearing a dress on the bus. And now he's been insisting on being called Loretta. I think it's a problem. I don't care what you say. I think just talking about it might help solve the problem.
Really?
You
know?
Not something you want to hide. We've been out for a long while now. Things are getting weird. Things are getting weird on the old tour bus.
Can I come on board the tour bus, mister?
No, no kids allowed, really, for your own good. No kids allowed. We'll be done, I think, in September, and then we're going to go back in and start...
A new album?
Start making some more music,
all right.
Yeah.
That's good. Do you write on the road?
Yeah. We write in hotel rooms and backstage and any place we can.
I read somewhere that your favorite cinematographic experience was to shoot Wicked Games.
Well, it was fun. I mean, it was a pretty good gig. We were in Hawaii on a beach, you know.
Good video.
Yeah.
Well, how's the new one? We're going to see it. Can't do anything to stop me. How did that go? Did you like shooting that one too?
Yeah, that was a lot of fun. You know, that's colorized. The whole thing was shot in black and white, and then at the end of it, we went down to the place and had added on all the colors. We wanted to do that from the beginning. And everybody said it was a bad idea, and maybe they were right, but I always love those movies late at night that come on that are colorized. I always go, wow, I love that look. So if we look, you know, if we look like we have nice skin color, it's not real, though.
Well, we're going to see that real soon. And wish you all the best in the continuity of your tour. Thanks for dropping by. Everybody says that Chris Isaak is the most wonderful person and Kenny to interview.
I started that one.
And this is true. And this is true. Let me tell you, this is true. So thanks for dropping by and all the best.
A handshake is
all
I
get. Thanks for playing for us, too. Huh? Bye, Kenny. Have a good tour. Nice to see you again.
Thanks very much.
Thanks, that was great.